فإن آمنوا بمثل ما آمنتم به فقد اهتدوا وإن تولوا فإنما هم في شقاق.
الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على محمد رسول الله، سيد الأولين والآخرين، وإمام الأنبياء والمرسلين، والشافع المشفع يوم الدين، وعلى آله الطيبين وأزواجه الطاهرات أمهات المؤمنين وصحابته غر الميامين ومن استنى بسنته واهتدى بهديه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، حياكم الله dear brothers and sisters to this intensive course about the youth in Islam. Inshallah, as you hear that it's going to be for 3 days. Towards the end, we're going to have a little quiz. Part of this quiz is memorizing. Can you guys? We're going to go through a hadith. We want you to memorize a hadith. Some of them are short, some of them are well known. So it's easy to remember. And it is good to remember and memorize this hadith. Inshallah. Try, do your best, inshallah. Do your best. The first hadith, yani as you hear that, these hadith all are, yani I selected them based on what is related to the youth. And the first hadith is a hadith reported by Imam Ahmad, where the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, يعجب ربك من الشباب ليست له صبرا. يعجب ربك من الشباب ليست له صبوة. Is that difficult to memorize? Is that difficult to memorize? I need not necessarily all, but I need some. Those who are going to memorize, inshallah, are going by Jay. يعجب ربك من الشباب ليست له صبوة. 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 نعم. طيب. The hadith says, your Lord wonders from the youth who does not have sabwa, and I'm going to explain what sabwa means, just to tell you what the hadith is about. Sabwa means desire. Desire which is found with the youth, desire which is accompanied with enthusiasm to do things. Now, like, you know, playing, like, yeah, not necessarily to be haram, but when it is haram, then it is even worse. When it is haram, then it is even worse. Because usually the youth are so enthusiastic to do whatever comes in their mind without even thinking of it. Without even thinking of it. If you look, for example, who listens to music most? Youth, isn't it? Right? And maybe you see elders listening to music, but they are not as the youth. And if you look to who take drugs amongst all, yani, all around the world, youth, isn't it? Because once you get older, then you know that it was wrong. Youth. Who, yani, who tried to يعني commit zina, mostly youth, because they have the energy. Youth, all youth, and that's why, if you remember the hadith of that young man who came to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and he said, Ya Rasulullah, permit me for zina. Young man. None of the old Sahaba came to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saying that. But young man, because it doesn't mean that the young Sahaba did, but yani, this is the nature of the youth. So he came asking the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to permit him zina. Now, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam wasn't aggressive to him, wasn't tough to him, wasn't harsh with him, on him. But he spoke to him wisely, said to him, sit down. The man sat down. He asked him, making him to use what? Intellect, his aql. And that's why we are different from all animals. Because of the aql, we can think with it. Before we do anything, we can think of the consequences. He said to him, do you accept it for your daughter? He said, no. He said, well, everyone doesn't accept it for his daughter. Do you accept it for your mother? He said, no. He said, everyone doesn't accept it for his mother. Do you accept it for your sister? He said, no. He said, no one accepted for his sister. Do you accept it for your aunt? He said, no. He said, no one accepted for his aunt. What does that mean? The woman that you are going to commit zina with is going to be either mother, sister, daughter, aunt. One of these. So if you don't accept it, if you don't like it for any one of your female members, then why you do it with the others? You know? Why this man came to Rasulullah? Because of the enthusiasm to do this. Now, Rasulullah dealt with him this way, he thought. Very unfortunately today, the advisors do not use the way Rasulullah advised. And the youth do not think the way that young Sahaba thought when it was explained to him this wisely, he immediately accepted. Today the youth do not think this way. That's a problem. That's why you see the communities all around the world are suffering in trouble because of the youth. Because of the youth. I remember here, for example, we all know Imam al-Nawawi. We all know his books like Riyad al-Salihin, Arba'in Nawawiya, and explanation of Sahih Muslim, as well as his big book, Al-Majmu' in the Madhab of Shafi'iyya. But he has problem in Aqeedah, he's Ash'ari. Now, all these centuries passed, the ulama knew that Nawawi has this problem. But they accepted his books as good books because of the benefit in them. And they warn against the mistakes. Okay? The youth today come up with a different understanding. No. We have to refute Nawawi. We have to. One day, me and two of my brothers in Saudi visited Sheikh Hamad al-Ansari rahimahullah, the muhaddith in Medina at that time. One of the great ulama, one of the major ulama, especially in hadith. He has a big library. We prayed Asr by his house, and then we came first people to the library, and we found him sitting in a big couch, and he was big buddy, you know, rahimahullah. When he saw us coming in, we were still young at that time. He shook his head like this and he said, "Youth, we were about to hate the youth, but we can't hate the youth. Why do you think," he said, "they were about to hate the youth? Because of the wrong decisions made by the youth. Wrong decisions made by the youth. And also," he said, "we can't hate the youth because they are part of the community. We can't hate them." But he said that to elaborate something. Think. We have to think. And then he asked us about our names, our duty, and we told him. He was happy, and then he said, "Sit down." Then he told us why. He said what he said. We were about to hate the youth. He said, "A couple of days ago, a bunch of them came to here, and they sat there, and they had one of them as the head of them. And he started saying, 'Ya Sheikh, you have to take out the books of Mubtadi'ah from your library.'" He said, books of Mubtadi'ah? What are you talking about? Which books of Mubtadi'ah you want me to take out?" He said, the Sheikh expected them to maybe say Kashaf or Zamakhshari. It is there in the library of the Sheikh, and it is in the library of Masjid Nabawi, it's in the library of Islamic University, it's in the library of Maktab al-Dahir in Damascus, everywhere. Because the libraries do not hold these books to promote them, but these are books written in ilm. Even if they are wrong, we just mention that these are wrong, or some wrong things in them. Nah? So he said, "It is the books." He said, "What?" He said, "The books of Noah and Ibn Hajar." The Sheikh said one thing, and I want you all, especially the youth, the young brothers, to understand this bullet in mind. Do as what the Sheikh is going to tell these youth to do. He said, "You guys go, explain Bukhari and Muslim from all views of ilm, linguistically, historically, whatsoever. Hadith, mustalah, nahu, whatsoever. Tafsir, aqidah, and make no mistake. The condition is, you make no mistake at all. And when you finish, you bring them. We check them. If we find them, as you claim, then we take the books of Nawawi and Ibn Hajar and burn them." Hookah. The ulama themselves, they refer back to the books of Nawawi and Ibn Hajar. Those people, Allah Ta'ala gave them ability which is not given to the people today. Now, but again, Allah Ta'ala had decreed that no perfection except for the prophets and messengers. Every man make mistake. So those boys left and never come back. Now you think, before you do anything, think, because we hear some or so many objections from the youth to the eldest, to the students of knowledge, to the scholars, today, youth, young. And many of them even don't know Arabic. They don't know knowledge. They just come to practicing or even just come to Islam. And they start speaking about this and that. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Think. Yeah. See what Rasulullah said to that man. See what the Sheikh said to these people. So This is one of the sabwa. Sabwa is not necessarily to be in desires which relates to yani entertainment and like that. But even when you bring your own yani desire into the masjid affairs, that's wrong. That's even worse. It's even worse. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم did not permit that boy to commit zina because he's going to commit zina with one of the relatives of the people, then it is not permissible for you as youth to come to the masjid and try to destroy this avenue because you are doing something wrong to the whole community. To the whole community. So you have to show respect. Even if you yani object something, you're not allowed to yani propagate it and cause split in the community. No, that's not correct. That's not correct. We have to love each other, we have to cooperate. Nah? And then the other hadith which I want to elaborate, by the way, the questions after Aisha, that is for the public. Any question? If you have any question related to any hadith, you just please raise your hand. Don't delay it. Okay? Right. And then go back to any question related to the first hadith. So if you have any question in that hadith, you can ask now. If we move to the second hadith, you don't ask. Now. Which one? Our topic?
Yeah.
Right. يَعْجَبُ رَبُّكَ مِنَ الشَّبَابِ لَيْسَتْ لَهُ صَبْوَةٌ. صَبْوَةٌ مِنَ الصِّبَى. صَبْوَةٌ, the word صَبْوَةٌ comes from صِبَى or صَبِي, meaning the little child. You know what does a little child do? He does anything without any, you know, estimation of thinking or whatever he yani wants to do, he just do. Huh? But you, as yani somebody who is over yani 10 years, خلاص, yani, you need to think. Huh? You need to think.
What's the translation?
Translation. Your Lord is wonder to a young person who does not have sabwa, who does not yani look for desires. He's yani the youth and in the club, in the football field, and the wrong things. I don't want to name any of the wrong things, but any wrong thing. And he's, this boy is only in the halaqah of the Quran. He's with his Quran, with the hadith, with his classes. That's how he is. That's how he is. Now. And when you mention these names of the great ulama, most of them, not all, but most of them were like that. Take for example, Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahab memorized the Quran before 10 years old. Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Baz memorized the Quran, finished memorizing the Quran when he was 10 years old. Imam al-Nawawi, same thing. Most of these ulama, they use their, because this age of youth is the energy, yani power, ability. You can memorize like that. You can understand, you can, but if you use it, if you use it wisely, huh? يَعْجَبُ here, this has the attribute of Allah, which is عَجَب. So this is one of the attributes. We believe that Allah has this attribute. عَجَب. يَعْجَبُ رَبُّكَ. Right? The second hadith is a hadith reported by Bukhari, where he صلى الله عليه وسلم said, سبعة يظلهم الله في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله. سبعة يظلهم الله في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله. Seven people Allah going to give them shade or shade them with his shade when no shade except his. ما معنى هذا؟ What does the meaning of that? طيب, what do you think if I speak Arabic English? I love that. For you also to pick some of the meanings. طيب. طيب ما معنى هذا؟ What is the meaning of that? يوم القيامة, on the day of resurrection, تدنو الشمس من الخلائق قدر مين. The sun will come close from the people, a distance of 1 mile. كم تبعد الشمس اليوم عن الأرض؟ How far the sun today from the earth? Can anybody figure out? In miles. كم تبعد الشمس عن الأرض؟ ما المسافة بين الشمس والأرض اليوم؟ جاي.
Light years,
it's very far. How many light years?
Allah.
If I'm not wrong, it is, as they say, 150 million miles. Because, you know, like, see, this far, the sun is this far, and they are still speaking about, يعني مع أن الشمس تبعد هذا البعد عن الأرض, إلا أن العلماء the scientists يتكلمون and they speak about عن 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 ارتفاع درجة الحرارة في الأرض. Speak about the extreme increase in the heat of the earth because of the sun coming closer. نعم. كم تتوقعون تقرب الشمس؟ What how much or how many centimeters do you think that the sun coming closer to the earth? Nothing. But even 1 degree that the sun comes, then the earth going trouble. فتخيل أنت يوم القيامة. Think on the day of resurrection. الشمس تدنو منك قدر مين. The sun come close to you as 1 mile. وهذا المين اختلف أهل العلم فيه. This mile, the people of knowledge went on different opinions on it. هل هو ميل المسافة؟ Is it the mile in distance؟ أو أنه ميل المكحلة وهو عود المكحلة التي يوضع في الكحل ثم يوضع في العين. Is it the mile in distance or the stick of the or the eye coil. The coil. نعم. هكذا يسمونه. الكحل. The eye line stick. Okay. They call it meal in Arabic. طيب, guess what? How big it is? As big as a pin? Imagine the sun is like this to you. And the sweat والعرق يرتفع بحسب أعمال الناس حتى يصل إلى هنا. And the sweat goes based on your deeds up until it comes here. طيب. لا يوجد ظل. He started saying that on that day there is no shade. No shade, take it from me. No shades at all. No shade at all. طيب. You look for shade. There is only one shade. هناك تبحث عن ظل لا يوجد إلا مكان واحد ظل. إذا كان الجو حار when it is very hot in the summer وأصبح الناس يعانون من الحر and people suffer of the high temperature ولا يوجد إلا مكان واحد فيه ظل and there is no place has shade except one ماذا تتوقع الناس يفعلون؟ What do you think people doing? Going to do? تقاتلون على هذا المكان. They fight for this place, correct? لكن في الآخرة لا أحد يستطيع أن يأتي تحت الظل إلا واحد من هؤلاء السبعة. But in the afterlife, no one can come to the shade except one of these seven. المسألة ليست بالقوة في يوم القيامة. And the devil is actually not who's stronger can go there. والمسألة ليست بالأسبقية من يأتي أول يأخذ المكان. And it is not related to who comes first takes first. لا. المسألة يعني تأتي وتقاس بمدى استحقاق الإنسان للظل بحسب تحقيقه لشيء من هذه السبعة. It's only if you deserve to be under the shade based on how much يعني involvement you have to these seven qualities. طيب طيب إذا عرفنا هذا when we know that ما واجبنا تجاه هذه السبعة خصائص؟ And we know that what is our duty in regard to this these seven characteristics. أسمع منكم. Can I hear from you? خاصة الشباب. نعم.
You're asking which.
أنت من الشباب. Are you from the youth or the old?
I'm 24.
No, I said from the youth. Yeah, boy.
Is it so I didn't understand the question.
The question is. There are seven people
yeah.
going to be given the shade on the day of resurrection when the sun is closer yeah. to the people. Only seven.
Yeah.
Who can be from the seven? Is it based on your muscles, your fight for it?
Yeah.
Or it is because you come first? Or it is how much work you did to be يعني with these people. Which one is it?
I think it's your last one.
Last one. Nah. Last one. Definitely because Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is telling us. No shade except for the seven. Look now, listen and look to these seven. And see and when I'm وعندما أقرأ هذا الحديث I read this hadith وأذكر هذه السبع and he mentioned this seven أريد كل واحد منكم فضلا لا أمر I want every one of you يعني kindly فكر في نفسك وكم حققت من أي واحد من هذه السبع think of yourself and Ask yourself how much you have fulfilled of these seven. يعني to each one of these seven. لأنه ليس بالضرورة كلها لا كل واحد من هذه السبعة سيكون في الظل. Not necessarily to have them all in one. لا each one of these going to be given the shade. طيب الأول إمام عادل. The first. Imam who is just. ما معنى إمام؟ What is the meaning of إمام؟ هل هو إمام المسجد؟ إمام مذهب؟ إمام مذهب؟ إمام بمعنى أمير أو حاكم؟ Is it the Imam of the masjid? The Imam of مذهب؟ Or the Imam who is the ruler. Naam?
The Amir.
لأمير. لأمير أنت؟ طيب. هل منكم من أحد أمير؟ Is there any of you ruler? Cross it. يعني it's not for us. We lost one. ليست لنا هذه الحكام. طيب. الآن now أنا أريدك تفكر. I want you to think. طيب. هذه ليست لك. This is not for you. هل تذهب تضارب وتحارب وتقاتل من أجلها؟ Are you supposed to go fight and argue on this for it? لا. لا لا يجوز. It's not permissible. لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أخبرنا أن من خرج عن الوالي يقتل. Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us, those who rebel against the ruler, Muslim rulers, to be killed. من هنا نعرف. From here we know. أن الشباب الذين استخدموا في الثورات وما يعرف بالربيع العربي كلها شباب بدأت من الشباب استخدموا استخدمهم الأعداء أن هؤلاء مخطئون لم يفهموا مثل هذه الأحاديث in those all uprising and revolutions in the Arab countries today, and the like of them, in the past, in the future, in Arab countries, in non-Arab countries, and in this activity, and those who exercise this activity, we know that they are wrong. They are wrong. Yeah. Then Imam Adil ليست لنا. Imam was just. It's not for us. فإن لم يكن عادلا واجب علينا طاعته. If he is not just, it's obligatory upon us to obey him. ونصبر and we be patient. وهو سيحاسب and he is going to be a question. وسيحرم من ظل العرش and he is going to be prevented from the shade of the throne of Allah. هل حرمانه من ظل العرش عقوبة كافية أو ليست كافية؟ For him to be prevented from the shade of the عرش in the day of resurrection, is it enough punishment in your eye or not? Enough. خلاص مدام enough. We already told that him as a prisoner will have his punishment. We don't need to hustle and waste our time and, you know, let us get busy with our business. We want to be in the shade. That is my goal. That is my target. Let me work, let me think of how I can guarantee that. طيب. إذن الأول ليس لي. So the first is not for me. الثاني شاب نشأ في طاعة الله. The second. Young man who grow up in the obedience of Allah, meaning is he grow up obeying Allah, practicing. Youth playing outside, looking for football, enjoying this and that, him only in the obedience of Allah. What does that mean? Fasting, optional days, like you guys today, you're lucky, tomorrow is Monday. Let's see you fasting. Day is very short here. Very short. Day is very short. I think Fajr here is 6:20, something like that.
No.
Huh? And then Maghrib is? 4 o'clock. Huh? 4:15?
4:15.
Yeah, 4:15. How many hours is this? 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
10 hours.
10 hours.
Just
10 hours in cold weather. No thirst. You come to Medina, in the summer, people fasting, 14 hours, 50 degrees centigrade, working. So why you lose this? The Prophet ﷺ said, "الشتاءُ الغنيمةُ الباردةُ." Winter is the very easy booty for you, easy hunt. لكن أين الشباب؟ الشباب لا يصومون. Where are the youth? They don't fast. They don't fast. نعم. أيضا نشأ في طاعة الله. He grew up in طاعة الله, praying night prayers. Ask yourself, don't speak up, just think. Most of you don't fast, then cross it. Fail. You want to be one of these, نشأ بطاعة الله. How are you going to do نشأ بطاعة الله when you live in such type of environment? Not only يعني here it is worse, but even in the Muslim countries. I say this even to the youth in Medina, because they have entertainment. Rarely you see them in يعني, practicing. So we say to them, think of it. This is youth. You are young. You are youth. Are you going to remain young forever? No. I was before you. I'm still young. Don't make no. But now, خلاص, I'm over 50. I already have what to eat, what not to eat, how to move, what, you know, what to do. But you still young. Definitely, I am very sorry for my past, for my, when I was young, I did not do enough. But this sorry does not mean nothing. I cannot go back. على ليت الشباب يعود يوما فأخبره بما فعل المسيب. I wish that يعني youth comes back to me so I can, so I tell it what the old age did with me. Now, so one day you're going to say like what I say now. I hope I used my time when I was young. But hope is not enough. Hope is not enough. Like night prayers. Today you have long night. Long, long night. You sleep, you wake up, you sleep, you wake up, working, waiting for the sun doesn't come up. You have 14 hours night. 14 hours night. What is the night prayer? And when we say long night, look at it. Isha is what, 7 o'clock? 7:15? Huh? Half past 7. And the timing here is not accurate because some massage is 7, some 15 minutes past 7, some half past 7. Let's take the worst, half past 7. After that, what do you do? What do you have? Nothing. Put your alarm, set up your alarm, you go sleep immediately, or go, and if you want to take dinner, if you want to review something, let's say 10 o'clock, you already sleeping. Put your alarm, 2 o'clock, oh no, not 2, 4 o'clock, you wake up. Let's say 5 o'clock, you wake up. Make wudu, stand up, pray. Ask yourself, am I doing that? Just ask yourself, don't tell nobody. Right? Again, from ta'a, the obedience of Allah, sadaqah. Sadaqah to sirri, hidden sadaqah. Hidden sadaqah. How much of it you give it? How often you give it? What do you do to make money and go give sadaqah? In the past, many youth used to go work hard works to collect money and spend it for the sake of Allah. For the sake of Allah. Without nobody knowing. And instead of objecting the masjid, doing this, doing that, go work, contribute to the masjid without them knowing that you're the one who's doing. He knows. And then, this means when you do donation, this will make it easy for you to do another righteous deeds, righteous deed, like praying at night. Because today, you may find it difficult to pray at night, isn't it? You struggle, I want, but fasting, again, you struggle, hard. I love, I don't want to name any food, but I love this food and that food. So, what can make it easy for you is you do one good deed for the sake of Allah, hidden between you and him. No one knows about. This will, as they say, الحسنة تنادي بأختها. The good deed calls its sister. Come, come. يعني, if you give sadaqah sincerely for Allah, then this sadaqah will call, come, come, this is good man. Come. Because these are good deeds. They don't want to be with bad people. These are good deeds, and they don't want to be with bad people. Right? So you do the righteous deeds. شَابٌ نَشْأَ بِطَاعَةِ اللَّهِ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ could be anything. You be in the circles of the Qur'an. You be in the circles of knowledge. You study hard your religion. Be grateful to your parents. One of the major, major ibadat, to be grateful to your parents, to be nice to them, even if they are kuffar. Rather than they are Muslims, maybe they are sinners, but they have right with you. Yeah? Try always to compete, try always to compete with others, not openly, not making them knowing, but try to do many things. Look at this. Abu Bakr and Umar used to compete, but without any agreement. Right? There was an old woman in Medina, paralyzed. She cannot do her own business. Umar ibn Khattab used to go right after Fajr to her house to serve her without telling anybody. But when he comes, he finds the house tidy, clean. The sheep already milked. Food cooked, he goes one time, till many times, then he asked her, Mom, who's doing this for you? She said, Abu Bakr. No, she said, a man who I don't know. He said, okay, I will come earlier and see. And he came before Fajr, but he found the house clean, tidy. What is this? Then he, one night, was there watching. It was Abu Bakr. He said, nobody can win Abu Bakr. See how the competition between them. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسْ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ In that field, let those who want to compete there. Nah? ورجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد. And a man whose heart is hung in the masajid. Now, الآن كلمة رجل لا تعني بالضرورة أنه ليس شاب. The word man does not necessarily mean that he is not young. لا. ولا يتعلق قلب الكبير إلا إذا تعلق بالمسجد وهو صغير. The ألف المسجد وهو صغير. And the heart, يرحمك الله. The heart of the eldest cannot be found hung to the masjid, connected closely to the masjid, unless if he is somebody who used to come to the masjid regularly since he was young. It became part of his life. Now, look to Abu Huraira, was young. He was there in the masjid all the time with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He did not used to go to the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and stay with him. He is the one, كان أبو هريرة أكثر الصحابة رواية على الإطلاق. ما تزوج إلا بعد موت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. He did not get married until Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away. And he was one who narrated the highest number of hadith. Highest. وهو ما أسلم إلا عام سبع. He did not come to Islam except on year number 7 of the Hijrah. يعني لازم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاثة شهور وبضع ثلاث سنين وبضع أشهر. He was with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم 3 years and couple of months. مع ذلك هو أروى الصحابة. Although that, he was one who narrated the most hadith. روى 5,374 حديث عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. He reported 5,374 حديث. أقرب واحد له كان 2,864 أو هكذا. The nearest number to him was 2,864. شوف الفارق. Look to the yeah. حتى قال هو and he said إذا كان أحد أكثر مني حديثا فهو عبد الله بن عمر فإنه كان يكتب ولا أكتب. وعبد الله بن عمر من الشباب. عبد الله بن عمرو. عبد الله بن عمرو أنيس من الشباب. نعم. He, Abu Huraira said, if there will be anybody who have more hadith than me, it will be Abdullah ibn Amr, because he used to write, and Abu Huraira was illiterate. He did not used to know how to write. But guess what? Abdullah ibn Amr is not one of the Mukthirin in riwayat al-hadith. فأبو هريرة لكن إذا نظرت Abdullah ibn Amr, Abdullah ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Zubair, جابر بن عبد الله، معاذ بن جبل، أنس بن مالك، عائشة رضي الله عنها، كلهم من الشباب، كلهم من الشباب. You look to these names, all are youth. وهم من أكثر الصحابة رواية. And they are the ones who narrated most of the hadith. الشباب يجب أن يشتغل في كل جانب. And youth, this age, youth need to be used in every good way. In every good way. اسمع. قصة معاذ ومعوذ بن عفراء. The story of معاذ and معوذ, the two sons of عفراء. في معركة بدر. In the battle of بدر, وقف عبد الرحمن بن عوف. عبد الرحمن بن عوف stood. وكان عن يميني وعن شمالي غلامين. غلامان اثنان. There were two young boys to his right and his left. وهما أخوان. They were brothers. فجبذه من على يمينه من ثوبه حتى يدنو لأنه صغير. يريد يكلمه بكلام لا يسمعه أخي أخاه أو أخوه. He grabbed he want to tell him something that he doesn't want his brother to hear. Secret. عبد الرحمن بن عوف بن دار نزل إلى عبد الرحمن. قال يا عم أين أبو أبا جهل؟ said oh uncle where is أبو جهل؟ قال ما لك وله؟ said what's the matter with him؟ قال سمعت أنه كان يؤذي رسول الله وأحب أن أكون أنا من يقتله. He said, I hear that he used to bother and harm Rasulullah and I wish to be the one who kills him. And then the other one grabbed him. He bent to him and said, Ya Amma, Aina Abu Jahl? He asked him, where's Abu Jahl? قال ما لك ولا؟ قال سمعت أنه كان يؤذي رسول الله وأريد أن أكون أنا من يقتله. He said, I hear that he is to harm Rasulullah and I want to be the one who killed him. SubhanAllah. What a competition in that. تعرفون أبو جهل؟ أبو جهل كان ضخم ضخم جدا. أبو جهل was huge in size. حتى قالوا أنه كان إذا ركب على الحصان تخط رجله الأرض. Was said that when he used to ride on a horse, his feet touched the ground. وهذان الصغيران يريدان قتله. يريدان أن يقتله. ويتنافسان بذلك. These two young, they wanted to kill him. And they compete one another. انظر إلى الهمة. And وفعلا قتله. They killed him. تحين الفرصة حتى ضربا لم يمت ولكن أردوه صريعا. They looked for the chance and then they hit him till he fell down. ثم جاء ابن مسعود وقتله وهو من الشباب أيضا. Then ابن مسعود came and he killed him and he was from the youth. طيب مشهد ثاني another يعني incident في معركة أحد. إن بطل أحد شابان لم يبلغا الحلم. Two of the youth who did not reach age of maturity. قال جاء للرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يريدان الانضمام. They came to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم to join the army, to join the mujahideen. فردهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم refused them. لأن الشرط أن يكون المقاتل بالغا. Condition is that whoever wants to participate in jihad must be mature. فقال أحدهما يا رسول الله إني رامي. يعني لا يهم أن أكون كبير أو صغير لأني سأرمي من بعيد. الذي يرمي من بعيد النمل. He said يا رسول الله I am good in shooting. And you know that, يعني it does not need يعني it to be mature or something to shoot because he's not going to go face to face with the enemy. He's going, you know, those who shoot, they go back, in the back, or high place. فلما علم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه رامي قبله. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم knew that he is يعني good shooter, he accepted him. فقال الآخر يا رسول الله أنا أغلبه إذا تصارعنا أصرعه أنا أقوى منه. He said يا مسيح الله you accepted him I always beat him in wrestling. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أرياني. He صلى الله عليه وسلم said you both show me. فتصارع فصارعه فضحك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقبلهما. They wrestled and then he beating his friend. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم laughed and accepted them. انظر إلى أي حد. طاعة طاعة حب الطاعة في سن الشباب. رجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد. لن يكون قلبك معلق بالمساجد وأنت تحدث مشاكل في المساجد. Your heart cannot be linked to the masjid if you always make problems in the masjid. تأتي. الإمام تأخر. تنظر إلى الساعة، تنظر إلى ساعة يدك، تنظر إلى الناس. You come and the imam is late. You look on your watch, on the clock, to the people. It's bad. And وممكن يقول أقم الصلاة. And maybe he says call the imam. وممكن يقوم هو يقيم الصلاة. And maybe he stands and calls the imam. كل هذا من الخطأ وهذا يدل على أنك غير مطمئن في المسجد. All of this wrong and this proves that you are not having tranquility in the masjid. وتريد أن تخرج سريعا and you want to go out of the masjid quickly. إذا هذا ليس مؤشر على أنك قلبك معلق بالمسجد. This is not an indicator that your heart is linked to the masjid. نعم. أيضا يأتي بعض الأخوة المسجد ويجلسون كلام وضحك هذا ليس قلبه معلق بالمساجد. Some youth come to the masjid laughing, joking, playing. This doesn't show that their heart linked to the masjid. لكنهم أرادوا مكان يلعبون فيه. But they wanted some place to play in. وإلا الذي قلبه معلق ساجد يأتي مبكرا لينظر هناك وسخ في المسجد يأخذه هناك شيء يفعله لصالح المسجد يفعله. Otherwise they come early to see if there is any dirt in the masjid that they can't remove. Anything to be done on the benefit of the masjid so that they do it. That's the person whose heart is linked to the masjid. نعم. أيضا بعضهم يأتي إلى المسجد. And some of them come to the masjid. ولا هم له. And he has no worries. إلا الخصام مع إدارة المسجد. Except arguing with the management of the masjid. ما عندكم كذا عندكم كذا أنتم كذا أنتم كذا. Always objection, objection, objection. هذا يدل على أن قلبه ليس معلق بالمساجد. This shows that this person's heart is not linked to the masjid. لكنه أراد أن يخرج شيء في نفسه من الهوى. But he wanted to express something of his desire out, expose out. إذن إذا أردت أن يكون قلبك معلق ما معنى قلبه معلق إخوان؟ What does that mean when we say قلبه معلق or his heart linked or hung in into the masjid? يعني حب حب حب. إذا عندك أحد تحبه هل تعمل على إزعاجه أو تعمل على إسعاده؟ When you have someone, يعني when you say his heart linked to the masjid, it means love, love. If you have someone that you love, you work on annoying him or you work on يعني making him happy.
The
answer is no in the second. طيب لماذا مع المسجد يختلف الوضع؟ Why with the masjid it is different? يعني your lover is more important than the masjid. حبيبك أهم من المسجد. ينبغي أن نفكر. We have to think. فإذا سمعت أحد يتكلم عن المسجد انصحه فإن لم تنصح اتركه ابتعد عنه. So when you hear someone just speaking against the masjid, then advise him to fear Allah. If he doesn't listen, you just leave him. لا تعمل معه عصابة. Don't make along with him a gangster. A gang. وتبدأون في محاربة المسجد. And you start fighting against the masjid. هذا ليس جيد. ولم يحصل في الأمة تفريق إلا من هذا السبب. There is no split seen in the ummah as يعني bad as it is from this cause. شباب يريدون بعض الأمور لم تعطى لهم يذهبون يستأجرون مكان مقابل مسجد يعملون مسجد. Youth, they ask for things to be يعني done for them in the masjid. Not done, they go and rent a place opposite of the masjid and make it masjid. لا. هذا لا يدل على أن قلبك معلق بالمساجد. هذا قلبك معلق بالشهرة وبالهوى. This does not prove that your heart is hung into the masjid or linked to the masjid, but it proves that you only follow your desire. وهذا فيه مشكلة يا أخوان. This has a problem. نعم. وأنا أتكلم الآن عن مصيرنا يوم القيامة. I'm talking about our يعني situation in the devil's action. فلنعمل لذلك اليوم. لا ننظر إلى الآن فقط. Let us work for that day. Don't just look to the day. نعم. قال ورجلان تحابا في الله اجتمعا عليه وافترقا عليه. And two men. Love each other for the sake of Allah. Whenever they meet for that purpose. Whenever they separate for that purpose or with that love. ما معنى هذا؟ What is the meaning of that? هذا المعنى يبينه قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. This meaning, the meaning of this statement is clarified by the saying of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the hadith. أوثق عرى الإيمان الحب بالله والبغض بالله. The strongest rings of the iman is to love for the sake of Allah and hate for the sake of Allah. يعني الهوى لا مكان له. It means that desire has no place in here. نعم. إذا الحب في الله والبغض في الله. اسمع ابن عباس يبين لنا ما معنى الحب في الله والبغض في الله. Listen to ابن عباس telling us what is the meaning of حب love for the sake of Allah and hate for the sake of Allah. قال أن تحب لله وتبغض لله وتعطي لله وتمنع لله. قال من أحب لله وأبغض لله وأعطى لله ومنع لله فقد استكمل عرى الإيمان. He the one who loves for the sake of Allah, hates only for the sake of Allah, gives only for the sake of Allah. يعني does not give, holds for the sake of Allah. طيب نريد نفهم We want to know the meaning of this. الحب في الله لا يكون إلا على أساس الإيمان. Love for the sake of Allah cannot be except on the base of إيمان. فبقدر ما عند هذا الإنسان من إيمان تحبه. As much as this person have of إيمان, you love him. وبقدر ما عنده من العصيان تبغض ما عنده من عصيان. ولا تبغض المسلم لكن يبغض ما عنده من عصيان. And how much عصيان or disobedience does this person have, then you hate that sin from him, not him as a Muslim. Because Muslim, you cannot hate the Muslim. اللهم إلا أصحاب البدع, except for those people of innovations, الذين يعملون عن قصد, those who do the innovations intentionally. نعم. إذن لا يكون الحب من أجل يعني تشجعني وشجع قويين وقويين. Love for the sake of Allah cannot be based on you support me, support you, you. نعم لا. وإنما لله تحبه تريد الأجر من الله فقط. But you love him for the sake of Allah, you love him, so you be rewarded by Allah. هذا مفقود اليوم عند أكثر الناس. ابن عباس في زمان يقول وعامة ما عليه الناس اليوم في الدنيا ليس بالله. في زمانه ابن عباس in his time says that and most of the people today their relations is based on dunya not based on آخرة. حتى لو كان في محيط المسجد وكذا والدعوة في الغالب تجدها لمصالح شخصية. Even when it is يعني in the field of دعوة or the masjid or most of the times you find it personal advantages. That's it. That's it. نعم. إذا قال ورجل نعم 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 تحابا نعم اجتمعا عليه وتفرقا عليه. طيب هذا كان الرابع. الخامس this was the fourth, the fifth. ورجل دعته امرأة ذات منصب وجمال فقال إني أخاف الله رب العالمين. وأنا أريدكم يعني أن تنتبهوا لهذا جيدا لأن هذا يمسكم أنتم أيها الشباب. He said, and the fifth is a man who a woman of authority, power, and wealth, and beauty. Called him to do what? To do wrong with him. But he said, indeed, I fear Allah, the Lord of all universes. This I want you to focus on because this goes directly to you or yours. وأنتم أدرى بأنفسكم ومنطقتكم والفتن من حولكم مني ومن غيري. And you know about yourself, your area, and the fitan around you. You know that more than me and more than the others. وتعلم كم من المسافة بينك وبين الفتن. And you know, you're the best one who know how much distance you keep between you, yourself and the fitan. وذلك وجدنا كثير من الشباب زلت أقدامهم بسبب هذا الأمر امرأة. And that's why we see many youth, يعني their feet slipped because of this problem. Women. حتى إن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ما تركت بعدي فتنة أضر على الرجال من النساء وإن أول فتنة بني إسرائيل كانت في النساء. I never left after me fitna that I fear or that more harmful to the men than the women. And the first fitna to Bani Israel was with women. واليوم فتنة النساء كما ترونها كبيرة ولا أكبر منها في بلادكم. And today the fitna of women is, as you see, grew very, very big and nothing like it in your country here. The fitna here is no comparison to any place else. طيب ما الذي يحمي من هذه الفتنة؟ So what can يعني protect you from this fitna? قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الرجل أنه يقول إني أخاف الله رب العالمين. The saying of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that this man says I fear the Lord, Allah the Lord of universes, all universes. هذا ليس أمرا سهل على الإنسان يقوله. This is not something easy for man to say. لذلك يوسف عليه السلام وهو نبي من أنبياء الله لما دعته المرأة ذات المنصب والجمال ماذا قال؟ And that's why Yusuf وكان شابا. And that's why Yusuf was young. And he was prophet from the prophets of Allah. He was young. And that beautiful woman of the authority called him to do wrong with him. What did he say? It's not easy, Ikhwan, just to say, إني أخاف الله. Believe me. If the records are going to be opened, many youth would be found doing wrongs. Wrong things. Why? Because you are not exercising the thing that protects you. You want the proof? You don't fast except for Latin and Ramadan, something. You don't pray night prayers, you don't pray duha, you are not very well obedient to your parents, many things that makes you unqualified for saying إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ. Maybe first chance for doing the crime, you run for it. It's difficult, it's not something easy. At that time, at that moment when Yusuf was called by that woman, what did he say? The palace was empty. She was pretty. They lived there together. They know that no one will come at that moment. Then he said, as Allah Ta'ala said, فَاسْتَعْصَمُ فَرَاوَدَتْهُ الَّتِي هو في بيتي عن نفسي فاستعصم. ما معنى فاستعصم؟ She, the one who he was in her house, she seduced him to do wrong with her. But he did this thing, استعصم. What does that mean? استعصم, هذه السين إس أصل الفعلي عصم يعصم أو اعتصم. اعتصم ليس عصم, اعتصم يعتصم, اعتصم يعتصم. لكن هنا قال فاستعصم يعني طلب. هذه السين تسمى سين الطلب, مثل استسقى. استسقى يعني طلب السقيا. This scene is called scene of طلب, scene for request. استعصم means he asked for عصمة, protection. Like when you say استسقى means he seek, he sought for drinking or rain or, right? إذن هو استعصم, استعصم بمن بالله. الآن فكر يا أخي. Now you think. إذا فتحت هذه الفرصة, إذا جاءت لاحت هذه الفرصة لأحد الشباب, امرأة جميلة ذات منصب في مكان خالي, ليست هي التي ستدعوه, هو الذي سيدعوها. She is not going, يعني think of this very beautiful woman who has power in a very empty place and no one there except this young man. Who you think going to ask to call the other? I mean, young man. Normally, the young man. لذلك يحتاج أن نقوي إيماننا. And that's why we need to strengthen our إيمان حتى نواجه هذه المشكلة. So we face this problem. ونأخذ الحماية. And we get the protection. لأنه من لا يحميه الله ليس له حماية. Because he, the one who Allah Ta'ala doesn't protect him, he cannot find protection. نعم. ونعم. ورجل تصدق بصدقة فأخفاها حتى لا تعلم شماله ما تنفق يمينه. وهذا أيضا أمر مهم جدا. And a man who spends for the sake of Allah and hide to limit that, he give it out with his right and he hide it from his left hand so it doesn't see. Does the hand see? Does the hand see? It means he hide it يعني from everyone and anyone and whenever it speaks. طبعا it is not good to go and hide it, give it hidden and then you go speak about it. يعني you come and give the masjid sadaqah and then you go out and speak. يعني your friends complain or something like, oh, nobody is donating. And you say, Alhamdulillah, I donated. Man, that's not correct. That's not. You keep on donation and keep what you donate secret between you and Allah. Exercise this, ikhwan. Give sadaqah to the poor if you know them. To the masajid. Because especially here, ikhwan, in these lands, if it is not your donation, the masajid cannot exist. Cannot continue. Not, it is not like in the Muslim countries that the Muslim governments sponsor the masajid. No. You guys need to sponsor the masjid. And your sponsorship is not based on conditions. I pay, but the management need to listen to me. No, not like that. Not like that. That's bad. Then you are not giving for the sake of Allah. It is giving for the sake of yani yourself, your desire. So be careful. Don't lose your money and lose your reward at the same time. If you want to be so, I advise you don't lose your money. Because when you give out the money to the masjid, to the poor, and then you want يعني, some profit from it in this dunya, whether praising or position or like that, then you are someone who is, sorry for that, really mad, really fool. You have lost your money for nothing. You're not rewarded. It's not coming back to you. So give it for the sake of Allah and hide it and do not speak. Do not speak. The last is رجل ذكر الله خاليا ففاضت عيناه. شوف هذا جاء في الأخير لغرض ليس هكذا. He said, and Isa said, a man who remembers Allah when he is alone and then he cries. This came in the order, the last. It's not for nothing. لا. هذا رقة القلب لا تأتي إلا بعمل ما تقدم. The softness of the heart to the limit that you cry when you are alone does not come unless you do what preceded. You work hard on filling your heart with iman. وخصوصا أنتم هنا في هذا البلد, especially you living in this land. Because you come to the masjid, raise your iman by salah, you go out, burn your iman by what you see, by what you hear. So that's why you need always to be abundant. You need to do all this and more. And more. طيب هنا نقف حتى لا نطيل عليكم لأن أخذنا يعني قرابة الساعتين من وقتكم فلا نريد أن نطيل لا أقل من ساعتين. نقف هنا إن شاء الله تأخذوا الراحة إلى العشاء.
فإن آمنوا بمثل ما آمنتم به فقد اهتدوا وإن تولوا فإنما هم في شقاق